I have never seen this much salt in my life. This is just unbelievable. Why is there so much? This doesn't make any sense whatsoever. Wait. Hold on. Oh my god.
Bro, I'm coming up with a new game.
Damn, a blank check.
This is my new game.
This is Xbox. Whatever.
This is four.
This is my new game.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. You know the brain rot is totally real when even after a state of play, PlayStation fanboys still have to, for some reason, talk about Xbox. Now, I don't even understand how this actually happens. When you finally have some video games to properly look forward to, you still talk about the competitor. So I guess maybe you're more of an Xbox fan than a PlayStation one when you really think about it. Interesting. But honestly though, I gave the entire thing a 6 out of 10. It wasn't great, it wasn't good, but it wasn't as horrible as last year's, because really, whatever you had last year was absolute garbage, so being somewhat above that really isn't a big line to cross. Nah? But of course, even though you were still a mid of play, because that's actually what it was, pretty much the majority of those games are already announced or coming to PC, so we already knew that they were actually happening, and the ones that were actually exciting were just Death Stranding, honestly, because Lord and Savior Kojimbo knows all and does all, because my god, that guy is on shrooms, and I cannot wait to see what he has cooking up in the kitchen for this actual sequel for the game, because I love Death Stranding 1, and I cannot wait to play the sequel. But of course, we know it's going to come out on PC, because they... It always comes out on PC, my boys. Whole slate, baby.
Oh, yeah.
Coming right to you. But like I said before, we had PlayStation fanboys literally talking about how Kojima betrayed Xbox. That's going to be a new one to figure that out. And then to make things worse, we had our good old friend of the channel, the amazing Lucas, forgetting to take his schizo meds and having an actual meltdown about the state of play live on stream. This is gonna be a good one, folks. Saddle up. The Red Dragon says, oh, I'm sorry. The Red Dragon says, such a stark difference in Kojima Xbox announcements versus PlayStation. In the Xbox video where he's announcing a cloud movie, he doesn't smile one time. Seems like a Walmart transaction. During the Sony state of play, he's all smiles and laughing, fist bumping, truly happy, laughing, crying emoji.
I'm laying all my cards on the table here. I want us to have an honest relationship right off the bat. I couldn't help but notice that you got kids. How tight are you?
The Red Dragon issue! Look, I don't know what it is about you consistently doing the worst possible things you actually can, but this truly is one of the worst things you've done. Now, I know you're thinking to yourself, audience, what are you talking about, Alex? How is this so bad compared to what he's done before? There's no possible way. Well, if you look closely at the images that he posted, you're gonna see these red lines. You're thinking to yourself, what does that even mean? Why does he even care about these lines and how people are like leaning or facing? Aha, my friends, that's because the Red Dragon is literally pulling the old school Manosphere Alpha Chad Sigma Don't Be a Beta Rivolino move. That's right, apparently the way you are leaning in actual poses and pictures will determine whether you are alpha or not. And instead of actually just providing anything with science to back that up, Red Dragon goes ahead and is clear as day, admitting to himself he is a certified alpha man. This is so absolute cringe. You are sitting here drawing lines on people, determining how they are standing and whether or not they're leaning into each other, to then say how this is now a Walmart transaction and how that is bad. When even in the first picture that you posted, Kojima is literally leaning into Phil Spencer and the Xbox team, but you tried to make it as straight as you possibly could. My boy, you're about as straight as a curved road, let's be real. And then to go ahead and to use something so absolutely as something from the Manosphere really just goes to show the kind of person you actually are. Look, I'm gonna give you a tip about life, all right, Red Dragon? Anyone who tries to call themselves an alpha is not an alpha. They're more than likely a bottom, like you'll always be. Lube up, buddy. Daddy's coming home. Unleashed says, and just like that, the state of play has decimated the developer direct. PlayStation continues to slay. Fire emoji times three.
This is so weird. I think I'm actually done being horny. Oh, wait. No, we're not. No, we are not. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, here we go again. Here we go again, YouTube. We gotta use YouTube views to determine how PlayStation is slaying. You keep doing this to yourself every single time. Why do you constantly care about how many views a video gets or something else gets? We all know PlayStation is the more popular console out right now. But the funniest thing about all this is none of that actually matters. It doesn't matter in the grand scheme of things. Talking about YouTube views, about who got more views and which state of play or direct, really does nothing in the actual scheme. Because all this does is prove that you have literally no life, no girlfriend, no job, no future prospects, and you are in fact a neat. And if you don't know what a neat is, you should absolutely look it up, because that is exactly what you are. And the crazier part about this is the amount of people that actually like this tweet in agreeance with you. Look, you and your friends hanging around in a circle over a cracker, staring it down profusely while you're trying to actually focus as hard as you possibly can. Some of you will get that joke, some of you won't. It's perfectly okay. Look up soggy biscuit in the Urban Dictionary. You might learn something. Well, maybe one day figure out who gets the actual dose of protein. But for right now, it's definitely going to be you at the end. Because from what I'm seeing, the only thing you care about is trying to suck off your friend with both hands on each side. Because hopefully at some point, you'll get some sort of recognition in your life because your father didn't hug you enough. M tweets out a video, but before that he says hashtag state of play, hashtag stellar blade, hashtag Death Stranding 2, hashtag PlayStation, hashtag PlayStation Studios. Let's see what M had to say.
Hey PlayStation, I just want to say, all sins forgiven. You did good.
Oh my absolute Christ. I have never seen anybody gargle balls better than you have, my boy. Remy LaCroix is literally blushing at the amount of balls you can fit in your mouth in one fell swoop. How do you do it? How do you fit so many balls in those cheeks at once? To sit there and say, PlayStation, all sins are forgiven, as if they've ever sinned in your book in the first place. You're the same exact guy who's been complaining about Helldivers going to PC, and then the fact that you turn around and have an actual PC, so really, none of it would have affected you in the first place. Don't think I forgot, my mind's like a steel trap, I'm autistic, it's great. But to sit here and to do all these hashtags as if daddy's gonna notice you, Papa Herman, please notice me, I'm gonna forgive all your sins, you're the best, baby, to go over an absolute mid-showing about video games when they're all mostly third party, and on top of that, they're all basically coming to PC, to turn around and say, oh, sin, you're forgiven, as if you're like that guy on Twitter or TikTok who's been like, blessing the sins of people online and they've just been making memes out of them. You're not that guy, my boy! Just put down the phone, take a rest, go outside, touch grass, fuck grass. I don't care what you do, just get off the internet. Jesus Christ. 8Gers says, immediately after that state of play, I have absolutely no need for this trash anymore. Hashtag Xbox, hashtag PlayStation, hashtag Nintendo, hashtag state of play. And then 8Gers neatly, quietly places his Xbox Series X on top of empty plastic bottles in a clean trash bag inside of his house. I absolutely love how you sat there, unplugged your console, found the cleanest trash can you could possibly find, and then gently placed it inside of your trash can on top of clean plastic bottles as if nobody would actually notice you're doing this for internet clout. To sit there and do this is honestly the most cringe thing you possibly can ever muster. Because one, if you didn't like Xbox, why'd you buy an Xbox Series X? Which is honestly the really funny part about all of this. And two, to turn around and take this picture means you had to go back into your trash can and then pull your console back out, plug it back in, give it a little on the head and tell it it's sorry because you just wanted to get some internet points for that day. And the fact that people were like, yeah, bro, do it. You threw out a console on Twitter. Yay! You're so brave! Stunning and brave! Stunning and brave! You did it, folks! We got him! We got this one guy to act like a fucking moron on Twitter and softly put his Xbox into a trash bin to then take it back out after the photo. It never ends with these people. It never ends. And it's like they wonder why, like, oh, how come he's always making fun of us ponies? He's always making fun of because you act like this every single week. Hyped says Xbox gets experimental trash while PlayStation gets blockbuster Death Stranding 2 and new action espionage IP. Thanks, Kojima-san. First, now we're getting, oh, Xbox gets experimental trash. What do you think Death Stranding was, my boy? It was experimental trash. The majority of you guys hated that game for so very long until you found out that, oh, it's exclusive and it's got good graphics from Horizon. I can't wait to play it now. The second it went to PC, oh, that game's garbage. I don't want to play it anymore. So we know exactly how things are going to go with the second one right off the rip. Let's not face facts about this, okay? And then on top of that, to say that Xbox is getting experimental trash while you guys get the new espionage action game, you do know it's going to be a movie, right? Like, it's literally going to be a movie. Did you forget that part where he's like, it's going to blur the lines between movie and game? Did you forget that? Did you not put those two things together? Did you decide to omit that part naturally on your own? Get ready to play more movie games, my boy. You're literally getting experimental trash. Every time. Japan hates Xbox says Phil Spencer is pulling his hair out right now. Laughing crying emoji. Xbox gets an experimental multiplat cloud flop indie game while PlayStation gets the masterclass Death Stranding and now the spiritual successor to Metal Gear Solid fully exclusive. Good job at Herman Hulst. We are first class. I hearts emoji. Japan hates Xbox again. Tweeting out Kojima has killed Xbox. Xbox beggars need to learn their role. You'll never be first class like PlayStation owners. All the best Japanese games will skip your crap dude bro platform. Hardcore gamers will treat Xbox like a joke because it is. Kojima hates Xbox. Laughing crying emoji, finger pointing emoji. You absolute fucking
rockin' issue!
How does Kojima hate Xbox if he's putting a video game on Xbox? You literally tweeted out, they're getting experimental indie garbage, which makes no fucking sense because by that logic, everything that he puts out is indie because that's really what happens. To then turning around and saying, now he hates Xbox because they're getting an experimental game, even though at the same time, Death Stranding 2 will more than likely be on PC. And then on top of that, what's gonna happen is the new game that you're getting is also going to be experimental. And if you hated Xbox that much, then they wouldn't have put Death Stranding on Xbox PC Game Pass. So I need to know how
rockin' issue.
And the answer is going to be very
rockin' issue.
The most
rockin' issue.
Like you've never seen a
rockin' issue.
This
rockin' issue
in my entire
rockin' issue.
Wow. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the coup de grace, the very best of what we saw, here is Amazing Lucas losing his absolute freaking mind about the state of play.
I'm coming up with new game. This is my new game. Oh,
and now here with
this is more.
Is Visionary Game.
Oh,
Kojima-san.
Idiot, bro. You guys think he's a genius. He's a moron. You guys are just idiots.
Kojima Productions partnership.
Stupidest shit ever. This man will put. This man just combines stupid shit and then calls it new. Just like, look at this.
This is my new game. This is my new game coming out.
Oh, God, dude! What are we doing? Why? What is it
with this casual, well, I'm gonna say casual, what is it with this blatant racism that we're doing right now? Not only are you throwing out the voice, but also you're incredibly wrong because clearly you haven't played a Kojima game once in your entire life to say this, but the downward spiral of not taking your meds has to continue. Here we go.
I think Xbox has invaded PlayStation and has the heads in their head, bro. That's what I think. I think all the Xbox people have invaded PlayStation and have the creativity out of Sony. They have the creativity out of Sony. They're like, hey, we got a new fire that we want to create. We want to put out this. They're like, the creativity out of them. That's Stranding 2. What happened? Our work here is done.
I love how it always comes down to this. And every time Sony does something really mid or bad or not even good at all, apparently it becomes Xbox's fault. Ah, yes. Let's blame Xbox for what Sony has done and the games they decided to back and how they decided to put things together and the show that they wanted to do that has nothing to do with Xbox. Yet for some reason now, Xbox is the one causing all these issues at Sony. Oh God, it's like you guys literally are the worst sets of human beings on the face of the earth. Every single time, it never changes. It's always the same thing. We go from the racism to now blaming other companies that you're not even involved with in the company that you want to suckle off on a daily basis. But it gets worse.
And we will always fund whatever you have, Kojima. Konnichiwa, this is my new game. This is what you do as the player. Hello? Oh, it's talking to me. Oh, wow. Well, I have to move this over here to hear the frequency. Huh? Oh. Yes, we must protect the planet. Oh.
Enwa.
Just random shit, bro.
Enwa.
They fund it. They fund it.
I don't even know what to say. I don't even know where to go. I don't even, the fact that he did this live on his channel. How? Oh my God. They fund it. They sure do, my boy. Oh my God, bro. How are you so nonchalantly racist?
Bro, this is Xbox. This is Xbox. I'm convinced this is Xbox. This isn't PlayStation. This isn't PlayStation. And I'm sorry. I know you Dragons of Dogma or whatever this shit is, but no. This is a hard no, bro. Like, what am I supposed to think that is fun here? Fighting a giant troll with ice?
Enwa!
Fight a troll with ice. I'd play God of War 3.
You cannot be this absolute racist. You are a PlayStation fanboy. You've always been a PlayStation fanboy. Xbox has nothing to do with this showcase. Yet for some reason, you talk about this is Xbox. They have nothing to do with this. Judas is going to be a multi-platform game. It's not an exclusive, so you don't have to talk about this is Xbox. For some reason, I don't know why you guys always bring up Xbox. And then you have the gall, the audacity, the testicular fortitude to say you don't know why anybody would find Dragon's Dogma fun. And then the point that you go to is, why would you want to fight a dragon? And if you didn't want to fight an ice troll, you don't find that fun. Yet immediately, the first thing anyone's going to say is God of War Ragnarok and God of War 2018, where you literally fight ice trolls, and then you say the wrong God of War! You say 3, not even 2018, not even Ragnarok, you say the wrong one! How are you this
fucking issue?
Bro, I don't even like PlayStation and I knew you were wrong. This has to be a troll. This is a work. There's no way around it. This is a work. This has to be a work where you got that thing so incredibly wrong every single time and you're so fucking dense in your skull that you can't figure it out. You're bald. Take off the hat. You're bald, Baldy. Stop being bald.
Enwa.
You need to take your wee wee fong fong, whatever the f- y'all eat over there, cheese and wine. Get the by the PlayStation, bro. Let some real OGs take the job, okay? I don't know where the you from, but you just look like you speak French. You need to get the out of here, bro. Get some OGs. Get some
Enwa.
Some people who know how to make games as the head of PlayStation. Because I don't know what the you doing, bro. Bring Jim Ryan back. Get your tea and crumpets ass out of here, bro. How dare you show your face on this state of play?
I have no clue what he's talking about. Hulst is not a French last name. It's also not an English last name. Holst. It's neither one of those two things, so I don't know how you got French, and I don't know how you got tea and crumpets mixed up with French cuisine. So we went from cheese and wine to tea and crumpets, and then not even picking the right setup of his work. Oh, God. No. I just don't. Oh, my God, dude. And then you want Jim Ryan back. You want Jim Ryan. Jim Ryan. That's the guy you want back. Jim Ryan. The guy who ruined PlayStation, who raised all the prices, who did everything he could to screw you at every opportunity. That's the guy you want back? The guy who literally raised the cost of the console, raised the cost of online, raised the cost of games, gave you nothing in return, but because you got Spider-Man and God of War, hey, you're the best, Jim Ryan. We love you very much. When you finally have some actual differences in video games, you just want the same exact thing. Lucas, you are an insane psychopath. There's no way around it. There's no buts about it, my boy. You are an actual psychopath, and I hope that one day you get your meds, because clearly things are not going the way you want them to, and you are that angry about a state of play in video games, for Christ's sake. So ladies and gentlemen, like we say every single week, it never pays to be a fanboy, whether you're sucking off a corporation, trying to use Manosphere claims inside of actual fanboy wars, which that explains a lot of how things actually operate now, doesn't it, really? And then going around and talking about how certain companies are dead, even though they're getting the same games from other companies and other publishers and other developers. Either way, it never pays to do that, because all you're doing is making yourself look like an actual clown and showing up here every single week in this content being made fun of and everybody laughing at you. We're not laughing with you, we're laughing at you. There's a very big difference. So as always, if you liked today's video, thank you. If you didn't like it, fuck you. If you want to see more of this kind of content, subscribe. We're getting close to 62,000 subs, and I just want to say thank you guys so absolute very much. It really does mean a lot, because we are doing more PC port reviews, gaming news, Steam Deck videos, emulation content, and streams every Saturday night at 8:45 p.m. Eastern, where chat berates me with TTS for about 4.5 to 5 hours, and I get called bald, a furry, I have a foot fetish, and now, of course, I have a P.O. box where people send me things, so check that out as well. If you want emotes during those live streams and also access to the Discord, consider becoming a YouTube member. It's as low as $1. If you don't want to join that, that's perfectly cool. If you don't want to spend it, that's perfectly fine. Just come on down and hang out. You'll have a great time either way. With that being said, y'all, I want to say thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time. Just stop.